Good evening. The conversation about the overwork of schoolboy footballers has surfaced once more with the man in Da Costa and the Flow Cups in full swing. Two trophies have already been decided as the wheat has been separated from the tares, and the big dogs of schoolboy football supremacy are now duking it out for the other cups on offer. It means that the top football teams are at times playing more than one match per week. These matches at this stage of the game are played to finish, meaning a team could be asked to go extra time and penalty kicks to decide a winner of a particular game. Speaking on TVJ's Eye on Sports, sports medicine specialist Dr. Paul Wright and medical practitioner Dr. Andre McDonald both expressed concern, with Dr. Wright going as far as saying the workload on the young players amounts to abuse. Dr. McDonald was a bit more measured, but urged the schools to ensure that the requisite nutrition and rest regimes are in place for the players. The current schoolboy football structure does put rigor on the legs of the players in a relatively short period. In fact, a school chasing all four titles has a total of about 24 matches to play. Although it seems like a lot for a young man to cope with, I do not think it escalates to abuse. 24 matches for a teenager is not a lot of games. In fact, it is too few games for the development of a football program. The truth, though, is that the ISSA competitions are not about development of the football product per se, but rather a somewhat extension of the physical education component in our schools with the bells and whistles attached that sponsorship can support. The football season runs from September to December and has to make way for the other extensions of PE, such as cricket and track and field. It therefore means ISSA has very little wiggle room with which to work. The principals now have to go back to the proverbial drawing board to revamp a system they tried to this season. I suspect, though, that there is precious little that can be done. It is for this reason that the big schools chasing titles have considerable money supporting their programs. Schools serious about a title challenge must have a large squad so that players are rotated. There must be a strong nutritional support system which ensures that the boys are well fed and provided with supplements and other nutrients. In addition, the bond between school and home, as well as that between the coaches and the teachers, have to be close to ensure that the boys are well rested and that they get extra assistance with their schoolwork during the heavy September to December period. In order to prevent breakdown during this high intensity period, all hands must be on deck. I'm Karen Madden. Good evening.